The Archbishop of Gandhinagar, who appealed against nationalist forces saying that they should be curtailed during the Gujarat Assembly elections, has now issued another statement. Archbishop of Gandhinagar Thomas Macwan said that we should all be allowed the freedom to question the country that we are living in. In a letter that was circulated earlier, the Archbishop of Gandhinagar appealed to people to curtail the spread and rise of nationalist forces in the country. He warned against the rise, saying that churches were being attacked and minorities were being targeted. He's now issued a statement against those who were trying to attack him for that statement. He said that he has the freedom of expression, that's his fundamental right, and he also has the freedom to question the country and its politics.
We have the freedom to be an Indian, as a human person, as a human being. We have our freedom to live, but then when we read even in the dailies or on the TV, when we come across certain incidents, we begin to question, where are we heading to? And so it is a daily affair, and it is happening very rampantly in our country, and that is a sad thing. We are giving a bad impression of our country to the world at large. I believe that India is a leading country. India has got a high spirituality. India has got very high morals and principles. And if we stick to these principles, our country can really grow, multiply, and everybody would be respected. And we will gain respect even outside the country.
Archbishop of Gandhinagar Thomas Macwan making headlines there. A letter written by him has gone viral on the social media, where he's appealing to the people, saying that they should make an effort to curtail the rise of nationalist forces. He said that there is an opportunity that has presented itself in the shape of Gujarat elections, and that people should ensure that these forces don't come back to power in the state. The Archbishop also reportedly told our reporter earlier that the letter was written to be circulated to other churches in the country and was to be circulated amongst Christians who come to offer prayers or for Sunday Mass at churches. Of course, after the story made it, after the story went viral on the social media, he's issued another clarification, and he's also hit back at critics who've questioned him for his political stance. The Archbishop of Gandhinagar has said that he has the freedom to question the country that he's living in. It's his fundamental right. He has the freedom to express himself. Let's once again listen into that statement made by Archbishop Macwan.
We have the freedom to be an Indian, as a human person, as a human being. We have our freedom to live. But then when we read even in the dailies or on the TV, when we come across certain incidents, we begin to question, where are we heading to? And so it is a daily affair, and it is happening very rampantly in our country, and that is a sad thing. We are giving a bad impression of our country to the world at large. I believe that India is a leading country. India has got a high spirituality. India has got very high morals and principles. And if we stick to these principles, our country can really grow, multiply, and everybody would be respected. And we will gain respect even outside the country.
The Archbishop of Gandhinagar, they're making a very bold statement, saying that the country should rise against the spread of nationalistic forces. He's saying that the rise of such forces is giving India a bad name internationally. He's also said that churches are being attacked on a daily basis. Minorities and OBC and weaker sections of society are being targeted. He's claimed that the Gujarat elections present an opportunity to the people to elect a government which doesn't endorse this ideology. Very carefully, the Archbishop hasn't named any political party or any leader, but he's appealing to people who follow his faith to not vote for nationalistic forces. This statement also becomes important because it's very rarely that we see political statements coming in from Christian priests and leaders. There are several fatwas that are issued by Maulvis and Maulanas that we hear of frequently, asking Muslims to vote for a political party during the elections or the other. But it's very rarely that we hear an archbishop or a Christian priest making a political statement. Let's once again listen into that statement by the Archbishop of Gandhinagar.
We have the freedom to be an Indian as a human person. As a human being, we have our freedom to live. But then when we read even in the dailies or on the TV, when we come across certain incidents, we begin to question, where are we heading to? And so it is a daily affair, and it is happening very rampantly in our country, and that is a sad thing. We are giving a bad impression of our country to the world at large. I believe that India is a leading country. India has got a high spirituality. India has got very high morals and principles. And if we stick to these principles, our country can really grow, multiply, and everybody would be respected. And we will gain respect even outside the country.
The Archbishop of Gandhinagar there saying that India is a secular country and everyone's rights need to be respected. He's saying that there's a lot of respect that people have for India, its culture, its history and its traditions. But what's happening now in the country is getting a bad name internationally as well. He's saying that the rights of minorities are being compromised. He claims the churches are being targeted. The Archbishop of Gandhinagar claims that the Gujarat elections present an opportunity for the people to vote for a humane leadership. We have Jumana Shah who's with us live this afternoon. Jumana, the Archbishop of Gandhinagar once again reiterating that he's entitled to his opinion as a citizen of this country. It's his fundamental right to express what he feels and to question the government in power.
Yes, so this is what he's saying, that he's saying that, you know, he has a right, he would like to, and he's not, rather the community, though it's a very, very microscopic community, they would like their vote to be counted. And it is important for the community to speak up, however irrelevant as an electoral force they might be, but they are citizens of this country, and the constitution, as you might have heard, he reiterated, the constitution gives them the right and the freedom and to exercise their wishes and their desire to practice the religion as they see fit. So he said that, you know, there have been every single day there have been attacks on minorities, especially their faithful and their churches. And this is not, he's not saying this just about Gujarat. He's saying this for across the country. And the appeal that he's made, the letter that he's written, is essentially to churches all across the country. And he said that we should be, the faithful and the bishops in each of these churches should offer prayers so that the people, the faithful who come to the churches, can elect a humane leader, somebody who understands the issues of minorities, the OBCs and the other backward classes, and so essentially the insecurity that, you know, marginalized sections feel is what he is voicing in a way.
Right, Jumana, and has there been any sort of threat that he's facing, any demand for security or request for security that's come from him? He's been forced to issue a clarification within days of that letter going viral on the social media.
He did not talk about a threat to us today, no. He did not mention anything about it. The letter was written by him on the 21st of November. What he did clarify was that the letter was not meant for media circulation. It was meant for only the churches, and it has somehow got leaked outside, which was not the purpose of the letter. It wasn't meant to be made a public statement. It was meant for internal consumption.
And you know, Jumana, as you said, that he's also, this is a general appeal that he's making to all the people of the country or all the Christians in the country, saying that they should work towards electing a humane leadership in the country. But he's also specifically mentioned the Gujarat elections, saying that the Gujarat elections presents an opportunity for the people to vote for a more humane leadership.
Yes, yes, yes. So he's also said that Gujarat is the place where a lot of things have started and a lot of changes have been initiated from here. So it's a good time now, Gujarat elections are here, to maybe initiate one more change. And this is in that direction and in that vein. He said that let's begin a new, something new, let's start it from here. So as you would have heard it in his interview, he is not, or even in his letter, he is not making a direct statement on any political party or a political leader. All that the closest he's probably getting is he's talking about nationalist forces. That is all that he's saying. So that's how he's going about it. He's not making, and he clarified that in the interview also, it's not a political appeal. It's an appeal to, you know, make your vote count to the faithful. That is how he has been repeatedly saying it.
Absolutely. Jovana, you're pointing out very carefully there that the Archbishop of Gandhinagar has not named any political party or any leader. He's basically written a letter which he said was meant to be circulated amongst churches across the country that said that people should be asked to spread the message of peace and that people should be asked to vote for a more humane government. You know, but this is obviously a very political statement there, Jovana, that's being made by the Archbishop. It's very rarely that we hear of such statements coming from the church.
Yes, it's a very, very rare thing. Though he did point out to begin with that we do reach out to our churches and we do sort of, you know, tell people, spread awareness that they should cast their vote, that sort of thing. But it is rare for a church or rather an archbishop to come out. He's the senior most person in Gujarat right now, though he calls himself first among equals, but he's essentially, that's how the order of the church would be. He could be considered the senior most person in Gujarat right now for the Roman Catholic Church. So it's a rare thing, yes. It's definitely a rare thing.
And, you know, Jovana, he's also talking about how churches are being attacked across the country. He's saying that the rights of minorities are being crushed. He also claims that members of weaker sections of society, the poor, the OBCs, are being denied their fundamental rights under the current regime.
Yes. So he's saying that, of course, he reads about it in the papers and also the media, but he also says that over and above that, he keeps getting representations from different parts and people that he's in touch with on the ground. So he has primary as well as, he's quoting primary as well as secondary information and sources for this surmise that he has presented, that people and churches, faithful, are attacked pretty much every single day.
Jovana, thanks so much for those details. We'll keep coming back to you for more reactions to the story.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.